24-hour get-home bags aren't as popular as they were in previous years, and it might be due to the decline in humanity's principles and rapid growth in AI technology. It's either that or I'm logged into the wrong prepper form. Now that I'm thinking about it, the site's login page always has weird pop-up ads of anime Sailor Moon girls in G-strings, so I guess that may be a cause for concern. But the focus isn't on the lack of malware protection, on how to overcome viruses so that it doesn't run off survivalists who are just looking for like-minded people to network with, but to overcome adversity when you're at a pastry shop in downtown Austin and all of a sudden a Red Dawn invasion happens. You're caught with your pants down, knowing you weren't prepared because all you wanted was to end your weekend run on Town Lake with the breakfast pastry and some coffee. You're trying to figure out why, out of all places, this would ever happen, then all of a sudden forget that the nation's leader is the laughingstock of the free world. So, anything is possible in this particular moment. You're 45 minutes away from your home, so even if you wanted to gather up the team, you'd have to run back to your truck and grab the necessities to make the call. I guess this goes full circle about how we've evolved around artificial intelligence dethroning nature's instinct to make decisions, because boy, that get-home bag sure does sound nice right about now. But before history repeats itself and you become an ancient ancestor people will learn from and tell their kids' kids about how 24-hour kit bags should be taught in every elementary school, you get the opportunity to lay the foundation right now. Your odds of survival will determine how you set up your get-home bag according to your location on the map. Your geography coordinates plays a pivotal role because the contents in your bag should not include moccasins and a Canada Goose parka if you live in hot and dry areas if you're a Texan like myself. In survival scenarios, all weather conditions are free game. If you're wondering, yes, that means you still get the option to model off your little coyote fur with duck trim raincoat while running from invaders as they hover in parachutes. Like all carrying kits, the base of the contents that includes your setup plays an impact when developing your go bag. The Vertex EDC ReadyPack 2.0 is a viable foundation. And then some. The guts of the 2.0 has a real estate that gives you the endless possibilities to shield off whatever threats are at hand. But this is supposed to be your get-home bag. You can't get all cute thinking of Chris Vector and the Spirit of Systems over with 5-pound plates that are accessible for a 100-mile hike through 95-degree heat. Instead, a 10x10-inch Level 3A soft armor by Premier Body Armor will do the job just fine. The upside of this is that it takes up minimal space in your go bag, and you also get the opportunity to run a slick plate carrier if the situation presents itself. Both cost efficient, lightweight, and the protection needed for the mission. Micro chest rigs are welcomed, but so is taking advantage of the basic equipment in front of you while utilizing all of its qualities, aka the EDC ReadyPack's hook loop system. Distributed evenly throughout the bag, if done right, you can build your own defensive blueprint using special pieces that can accommodate the bag with Velcro compatibility. To keep things on a budget side, Vertex offers multiple accessories like the single mag pouch and the mag full pouch, which can be used as support for your secondary weapon. Assuming that you already have an EDC on your person, you have a few options to operate with. You can either have more real estate in your get-home bag to load up on backup mags, or you can equip an OWB-style holster with Safariland's QLS setup using the EDC bag's hook loop system. I'm running our outside the waistband gambit holster on QVO Tactical's Velcro mount. I also find this a convenience to the average person who may include other contents in a bag such as an operator's belt where you're able to run another tactical approach as an option. And again, this is also user preference. So an MP5K with a 40 round stick may be your go-to backup. But if you're keeping your 24-hour get-home bag stowed underneath the backseat of your truck, you might have to think twice before basically giving away $2,800 to a scavenger who has been stalking you ever since you walked into the pastry shop. And I'm sure the cream-filled cheesecake donut isn't what he's after. Instead, distraction devices could become a viable option to the get-home setup that could beef up the defensive game plan. Incapacitating enemies with the M13 thermobaric device, and your little flanking problems go away. No, flashbangs aren't the answer to ambush situations, but the goal is to get home in one piece. A 5-second disruption could help you get away from your woes, or give you enough time to draw the Glock 19 from concealment and you can finally achieve the painting artist you've always hoped to become. Smoke devices, on the other hand, aren't too messy if you know what I mean, but it does add another wrinkle to your getaway plan. Oh, and those two water canteen pockets on each side of the EDC ready pack, don't say I didn't give you an alternative for a plan B when those dire circumstances arrive. But let's just say things do get wet and chaotic, like, I don't know, Mother Nature arriving. If your 24-hour time period makes a left turn and ends up looking like a 3-day marathon, you want to be prepared and well-suited for those particular moments. For the past few months, the team and I at the Think Through Tactical headquarters have been trying to find gear suitable for all environments, yet compatible for mobile operations to give the user the advantage. The end result is that we teamed up with the guys at Champion and came up with an all-weather jacket designed to keep you dry from all-terrain conditions, dripped in camo. This wind and rain-resistant pullover is the unsung hero to your 24-hour get-home bag. You can break glass in case of an emergency, or you can pack a hoodie capable of stuffing itself in its own zip pouch pocket, reducing its size drastically to a 6x7-inch fraction. And if you ask me, I'm picking the jacket constructive of 100% micropoplin, meaning that not even pneumonia itself can penetrate the design. Okay, that's not supposed to make sense, but you understand what happens when you combine soaking wet hair and freezing temperatures. We've even stamped our logo on the left side of the chest area to back our confidence behind the layout. There's a kangaroo pouch located below the zip pocket for whatever accessories you find typical. The adjustable bungee drawstrings at the hood and bottom of the jacket keeps the upper body concealed through whatever element you're facing at the moment. For those wanting more information on our all-weather windbreaker, we'll leave a link down in the description below. When the odds are against you and you're at your most vulnerable state, then considering a gas mask to your get-home bag would be the turning point to your survival. I mean, with the created space used from consolidating our packable jacket, you'd be nuts to not fill it with a reputable item that's been in service since the early 90s. The US M40 Field Protective Mask is a tried and true piece of equipment used on a battlefield that protects you from chemical and biological agents, as well as any other folklore fairy tale particles we've all distilled in our minds, because let's be honest, we still hope for our childhood chaotic dreams to come to fruition. The M40 gas mask has a unique superpower compared to the other masks you've seen throughout our channel. It adopts an extra rubber skin covering the mask for additional protection against most common agents. You're increasing the chemical resistance of the mask, yet still able to harness all of the other common capabilities, like the 40mm filter threading and a wide variety of interchangeable parts. The field of view is permissible, giving you decent clarity when focusing through the lens, but the modularity of the mask makes your sight picture and alignment supreme when firing through red dots and such. But if you're wanting one reason why you should add an M40 to your 24-hour go bag, its voice projection capability and mic adapter will solidify the needs because, communication devices anyone? Since we're on the subject, no one ever told me that the best $30 you'd ever spend would come from Amazon, aside from getting scammed into buying bootleg North American Rescue Cat tourniquets for half the price. The Baofeng UV5R might be the core of your loadout in 2023. Communication devices play a massive role when collecting information in catastrophic events, or in other cases, exchanging urgent material through multiple frequencies within your team, and utilizing user-friendly applications like a flashlight option, siren signaling, and the ability to tap into emergency bands to get the inside scoops in your local region are some of the things the UV5R handheld radio are capable of doing. The continuity of your get-home journey involves consistently being tapped into your environment and what's around you, so having a handheld ham radio like the Baofeng makes all the sense. To know more about the UV5R and all of its potential assets to your future loadout, I'll have some links down in the description. Water sources and food supply are the key elements for fueling your body on your trip back to your castle. Emergency rations contain the right nutrients to supply the body with the calories needed to keep going, yet small enough to be able to fit into your bag to free up room for other items. What I'm currently carrying can supply enough calories for a 72-hour trip, weighing a little over a pound. Water purifying tablets are appropriate for individuals who live near water streams or creeks. You'll get your best value out of this using moving bodies that contain a clear flow. The conclusion is that loading up on bulky foods or unnecessary water containers would just slow you down. That's unless you enjoy the thrill of having a target on your back. Oh, and shelf life. Keep that in mind. You'll thank me later. Medical supplies, like an IFAC with a couple tourniquets inside, are convenient if you have quick access. But it also depends on how the 24-hour get-home bag is prepared. Rearranging items in certain places so that efficiency is exercised is how you're able to make it home alive. The good news is that if you do live in the southern states, then you can use this configuration as a cheat sheet if you want to build yours for future reference. We've constructed these pieces in this layout to demonstrate that you're able to run this exact loadout throughout all areas of the world, even if you're in law-restricted places. To help those in search for the ideal 24-hour get-home bag, we'll contain all items in this video as well as pricing linked down in the description. If there are other items that you think would fit well with this get-home bag setup, feel free to drop a suggestion in the comment section. As for now, we're gonna go ahead and wrap this video up. To watch more content like this in the future, click the subscribe button. To get instant updates for the latest Pew Pew content, click the bell notification icon as well, and I'll see you guys in the next video.